What the devil do you call this, Prudence?
She's like having a cat in a gown.
I told me you made orderly and well, for him was back in one style.
Yes, I did, but if you recall, I did not tell you to moor it to the time, nor did I.
Clock,
we should be there about
you about. Now I ask you to give me back my patrimony.
Hold on, sir. You'll permit me to explain. Having come to Korea to collect the debt, my son informed me of a very serious case of love between your daughter and himself. And because of your good reputation, I shan't delay him long. I'm satisfied, like any good father, to have him married. And if you're content to save the marriage as I am, well, then after a marriage settlement has been reached, you will find me ready and willing and with my eager approval to agree to her marriage stand. For I cannot argue over the little details with you, Colonel Jesse, of whom I've heard such good things.
Well, sir, please excuse me for what I'm going to say here. Your frankness and conciseness pleases me a great deal. It's certainly true that your son Rufus here loves my daughter, and that she loves him, or else they're both great pretenders.
Shall I lead the way?
That's a good idea. I'll follow you.
At this short notice, you're likely to get a scanty meal, but we'll do better for you at Castle Rock.
I'll follow you.
Parson?
What did you want to say, Parson?
Well, you saw my master wink and laugh at you.
So what?
Well, he's left me here to help you discover the significance of his signs and gifts.
Well, please explain.
It's like this. Jesse Duke is taken care of, dealing with a deceitful father of a deceitful son.
And what about him?
Well, you're supposed to take
son was well loved in Perea. Excuse me. Put aside all trivial details. Would you please go inside? Tell Master Lucas that his father has arrived from Balsarock and is waiting outside to speak with him.
His father? Well, you must be lying. His father is here standing at the window.
Are you his father?
Well, yeah, so his mother said. I can believe her.
Wait a second. What do we have here, gentlemen? This is outright deception to take another man's name.
Well, it is. Grab that liar. I believe he means to cheat somebody in this city by pretending he's me.
Like my plan, Linda's back.
heated war is finished, to smile and pass straight to danger. Lovely man, welcome my father, while I with equal kindness welcome yours.
Happy.
Brother Hans, Sister Kate, and you, Hortense Fire, with your lovely widow, feast with the best of them and welcome to my house. My dessert is to steal our stomachs as well as our wonderful reception. Therefore, sit to talk as well as eat.
Nothing to do with sitting, eat.
Ray offers nothing except for his kind.
Well, but for both our sakes, that word were true.
Well, now by my life, Horton Esquire fears his wife.
Well, never believe me again if I say I'm right.
Well, you were very sensible, yet you misunderstood me. I mean, Horton Esquire is afraid of you.
Well, but didn't an answer in the world since.
Round with the fly?
What did you mean by that? Well, just about conceived to me.
Conceived by me to me? What do you think of that, Horton?
My widow says, thus she conceives from the tale.
Very nicely explained. Kiss him for that, widow.
And I ask you again what you meant by that.
Well, your husband tested by a shrew, just as my husband struggled to be his own. Now you know what I mean.
A pair of
exactly. I meant you.
A genuine date compared to you.
Bart, where's my wife?
Well, sir, she thinks you're playing some kind of joke on her, and she won't come. She bids you to come to her.
Thank you.
unwise obedience has cost me 100